very short notice to you. Still, you have accepted, and it's our privilege that you are here to address the students and faculties. Thank you very much. Over to you, Saurabh sir.
Thank you, Dharmesh sir, for a very elaborative introduction. In fact, I would also love to address the gathering of the IT professionals, because my core domain is also on information technology. I did my PhD in the similar technology field, and there are many startups wherein I am actively engaged and supporting are also technology enabled. So this is a right forum to share my expertise, share my know-how, knowledge, experience, and guide our students. So I was told today to have an induction program for the innovation ambassadors. So there is an initiative of MHRD, Ministry of Human Research Development, to enable the education ecosystems with the innovation, which is a very much important criteria of any engineering institute, specifically to learn from the basics. So this IIC, which is an Institute Innovation Council, is a kind of a very established body which takes care of the innovation at an institute level. And this is a very one of the nice initiative taken care by MHRD, and with the impact of this initiative, I have observed that there are many innovations are now coming from the school and colleges. Even a first year or a second year student has also started parallelly to work on one of the tech enabled startups. And this is the reason, if you see in the last half a decade, EdTech industry and the technology enabled startups are flourishing, and heavy funding is also coming to India due to these technology enabled startups. If you see the top 10 unicorn of the country in the startup ecosystems, they all are the technology startups, be it Byju's, be it Ola, whichever you see, Grofers, whichever you see, they all are the technology enabled startups. So there is a lot of opportunities now coming, and to this pandemic time, only technology is becoming the sustainable backbone of anything we do. Due to this technology platforms, we are able to continue what we are doing, not only in the education, but in the many fields, this is helping a lot. So with this brief, I am going to present my screen, and I have been given another 50 minutes to speak, wherein I will try to cover up everything in 40 to 45 minutes, and we'll be open for the question and answer. Meanwhile, if anyone has a question, I do request to drop into the chat box, and later on I will try to address all the questions. Professor Sulabh, am I properly audible?
Yes, sir. Audible.
So, orientation to the innovation ambassador. Throughout this discussion, we will see the roles of the different stakeholder into the IIC framework. So, talking about Ganpat University Incubation Center, so Professor Dharmesh has already briefed a lot of activities about what we are doing at Incubation Center and how we are promoting startups in and out the ecosystem. So, sir has covered many aspects, but would again like to highlight a few things which is you need to know that we are the only incubation center at the state and the country which has a complete ecosystem of pre-incubation center, business acceleration, and growth acceleration. So we support the startups at an idea level, we support the startups at a business level, and even we support the startups as a growth acceleration level. These are the three different levels we are supporting through the Ganpati University Incubation Center. Now, if we talk about the ideation level, is something where someone as an innovator or a group of people comes to us and request for validating their idea. They just have an idea in their mind and they want to pursue that idea as a business solution. So starting from that idea level to having a certain number of customer and you are generating a revenue, which is a business acceleration, and you are in the need of a heavy capital, which is a series of A or series B funding, and you want to have a working capital, you want to expand the business, you want to expand the production capacity and everything, then also we do support via the funding. So we are the incubation center which has, starting from idea acceleration to get the venture fund, the innovator does not need to move out of the ecosystem and approach anybody. So this is the beauty about the Ganpati University Incubation Center. We are going to talk about why IIC MHRD program is very important at your institute. So of course, so there is a little latency in slide change. So IIC is nothing, it's a compositions of a faculty, experts, and the student council. So first of all, the institute has to form a composite structure of different expert faculty of different domains, industry experts, and the students council. And they define together one academic calendar which is purely targeting the innovation and entrepreneurship activities at your institute. These activities may impart a critical thinking, idea validation, design thinking, innovations through different processes, and set up how to set up a entrepreneurial mindset. So this is the core objective of setting up the IIC under the MHRD's initiative. And all the institutes, universities are now supposed to form an IIC at their institute level, which can intervene into the academic and improve the innovation-based learning into the curriculum. So what are the major things we need to do is semester-based approaches for preparing and advising annual calendar plan for IICs. So different semester has a different learning. Different semester has a different blend of technology learning and blend of assistive learning. In that, you have to also incorporate the demand of the IIC, looking at the existing calendar of your semester. So this is a responsibility of a mentor faculty of each semester to look into the semester's academic demand and then try to offer the programs which is defined into the IIC calendars, which is almost a common calendar available on the IIC's portal, wherein we can slightly make a changes into the electives. And based on your semester's need, you can incorporate those all the activities into your semester. And this goes round the year. So semester wise semester, the outcomes will be reported onto the every quarters, and that will be stored into the portal monthly, and based on that you will be evaluated. You have to also include certain learning modules for activities to plan into the academic calendar. This learnings module can be online or an offline. There are a lot of courses available on IIS portal and Swayam portal as well, which can be opted by students as an individual or a group of team. And the result of that courses can be also submitted to the institute to be considered as an activity of the IIC. There are certain self-driven and MIC-driven activities with the different weightage and scoreage has been given to the inside the calendar. You have to make a point that all the mandatory activities into your IIC calendar should be targeted first. And then you have to quarterly divide the activities which are electives and put it into the structure in a way that you achieve the right scoring. So every activity is also followed by different types of a scoring mechanism. The higher you score, the higher the ranking you will get. And there will be a common ranking structure and the common awards has been announced every year by the IIC team. And we have to also keep the earlier learnings of IIC version 1.0 and 2.0. And looking at their best performance and best performance criteria, we have to also implement those criteria to our IISs immediately. There is also a quarterly based mandatory report submission is required. And as and when the new scoring and ranking mechanism has been introduced, IIC will, MHRD will also bring into the notice of the innovation ambassador. What IIC must do? So breaking isolation and enhancing the coherence and synergy. Of course, before the introduction of the IIC, we have been working and operating in a different way. Now, once you introduce this, you have to put an efforts to break the isolation and enhancing the coherence and synergy among the academic activities. MIC should prepare, IIC should prepare the MIC prescribed annual calendar, submit as a part of the activity, and also share with all the students and faculty so that they know at which day which activity is being planned. The calendar should engage the stakeholders, which includes the student, faculty, experts, and the institution, effectively and develop a healthy competitions among different IISs. So we have to keep an eye on the best performer of every year into the IIC portal and try to learn from their best practices and implement it. This is the way, this will not go into the monotonous way. It will make it more effective and engage the stakeholder. If required, you can create a different semester's WhatsApp group for along with the experts from industry and mentors from the academia and industry. And they will keep engaging them by offering them and providing them a different industry-led problems to be solved by your institution. Time on time, you have to also take care of specifically the early semester's mentors should have to take care of forming a team of the students, because team building exercise is the one which complements the strength of each and every individual and help solving the proper problems in a better way. You should define the self-directive activities. As I told, students can go to the Swayam portal and opt one of the open course and complete it and share the learning with the team and the IIC coordinators. Similar way, we have to also derive the activities which is directed by the MICs in the form of activities and event. We have to also take care that the report in a proper format should be submitted. And for that, the proper performa and the structure to be developed, documentation and report keeping mechanism to be developed and share among all the stakeholders, so that as and when they contribute something related to the IIC activity, they prepare the proper documentation as well. So this is the team responsible for running the IIC at an institute. So we have to deploy president, vice president, convener, innovation activity coordinator, startup activity coordinator, internship coordinators, IPR activity coordinators, social media coordinators, ARIA coordinators, NIRF coordinators, And as and where required, you can add any members. And I'm sure this has been taken care at your institute. IIC coordinators, a well-defined calendars for the IIC is a common and available to all on the IIC portal, as I already told. So we need to just at least follow the same calendar. There are certain activities which are mentioned as a mandatory. So in every quarter, we should make sure that we should not miss any mandatory activity. The way we are doing today's orientation session, which is a mandatory activity in IIC portal. Similar way, you have to identify and plan the activities which are very, very much important, mandatory and high scoring activity. Apart from that, I'm not saying that the electives are also okay to not do. We have to plan the electives activity in a high scorer manner and prioritize the activity in a way that we ended up every quarter scoring at least a star with a proper score ranging between 16 to 20. So I told you already the calendar mentions the mandatory and elective activities. We have to plan the activities accordingly and submit the report quarter on quarter. What are the IIC's key important points to be considered? So at your institute level, you have to create a facility which engages both the important aspects of the incubation, is incubation and pre-incubation. Now, I'll take another minute to elaborate pre-incubation. So pre-incubation is something a layman comes to you with certain solution or a problem or a certain thought. Then your team should be, IIC team should be capable enough to validate that idea. Check that idea, give them a guidance, help them identifying the competent competitors and the market where the idea is going to be a part of. Guide them how to take the idea to the further level. If it is an individual's call, help them building a right team of an innovators, share the idea, craft the limitations and the outcomes of the idea. So this all comes under the incubation part. Once everything is ready, help students to prepare elevator pitch or business pitch or detailed project report, and then allowed him to approach the incubation center, which are in your case, we are the incubation center. So allow them to get in touch with us. We will help them for bringing the funding, because IIC do not provide the funding. Institute also do not have a funding, but we do have a lot of funding available to us. So every year we are spending lakhs of rupees in innovation and supporting the innovation. So once the pre-incubation part is over, you should recommend those startups to incubation center and we'll help them bringing the good tranche of funding, which allow them to develop a minimum viable product. This minimum viable product can be a technology product or a product which is tangible or a services which helps solving the society's problem. It could be anything. So allow them to reach to us. And in fact, in the case of pre-incubation also, you can engage any of our team member into the process, which also the formation of the IIC says that there will be an expert from the incubation center. And we will help them crafting and engaging with the idea validation process. Many times it happened that no team from the individual semester comes to you. In that case, there should be a design thinking workshop to be taken care, idea generation workshop to be taken care. And by doing all these problem solving workshops can be done, ideathon can be done, hackathon can be done. And by doing this, we will come up with certain solutions which are beneficiary to the society, helping creating an industry and has a capacity to generate the fund. And through this, the journey of a startup starts. The another important key aspect is an innovation. So students should be sensitized enough to understand what is innovation. Is it a radical innovation or an incremental? I mean to say, it is something which is out of box and you are the first time doing it, or it is something that someone has already done and you are incrementally adding some value addition into it, and you are hopeful that the customer will buy your solutions over the earlier proposal. So this is something the students should be sensitized on and engage on innovation activity. This could be start from even offering the practicals into the semester. We should not follow the year on year practical list, but now it should have a impact of the innovation into the practical of the each subject. Help them forming the startup. Now what happens once you have an idea, you have an innovation, you have checked that idea is valid and you got the initial funding, you have to immediately form a startup. You have to register a company, you have to register a trademark, patents or IPR, whichever the IPR is eligible to your innovation. And remember, for that also we have a funding, so nothing goes from your pocket. Only the efforts are dedicated efforts, better than efforts. The dedicated efforts are the only thing we demand from you, and also that is for you only. So if you start in the first semester, it may possible that in third semester or fourth semester you have already validated your idea. If you are starting from fourth semester, maybe sixth semester, you already validated your idea, you started working on the proof of concept, develop a prototype, have a minimum viable product and customers are using it. So these all activities should be taken care at an IIC. These are very important points of success if we want to have a star ranking IIC at our institute. We have to time on time share the vision of the Startup India exercise the government of India and the state government is doing among these stakeholders like students and experts, and engage them. We can have a different accelerator programs. Once we have a enough number of ideas available at our IIC, we can have a venture and angel investors meet. We can have IPR and patent filing workshops, hackathon. And we do have at a Ganapati University a tinkering lab. So if you want to tinker any idea, validate the idea with the scientific approaches, then also those kind of labs are available to us, targeting STEMS operations. You can approach us and we'll give you an access to those labs, and you can validate the idea with the proper foundation of the validation. So pre-incubation, as I told, it includes two types of major aspects. One is exposure for culture building, wherein you need to have an outreach program, literacy program on innovations, engagement with various stakeholders, roundtable meetings, mindset discussion, open talk, TED Talks kind of a talk. We at Incubation Center do the World of Startup talk, conducive and creative environment talk, some of kind of a like a enlightening talk by the successful startup, learning from the failed startup. Because see, there is a lot of learning engage even into the efforts of getting failed. So those kind of an exposure and culture building activities to be taken care, which is the main objective of this IIC, is to have a pre-incubation activities laid into your institute. Now in pre-incubation, idea and innovation activities are to be taken care, which includes design thinking, problem solving, pedagogy interventions, live projects, POC building, MVP building, common infrastructure and resources to be laid out and given to the students, partnering with different startups and business ideas, ecosystem building activities. So there are a lot of activities are also laid out into this pre-incubation part. Annually, we can have idea competitions, and we can give awards and achievements, recognitions to these all the startups. We can give them an exposure to the different level. I will share later on into this slide what kind of exposure to be given to the students. In incubation center, this is what something, of course, we provide the pre-incubation support as well. But in incubation, we have a startups and scale up both the models available. So we help the students developing a business model, mentoring them, marketing access and incubating them, industry linkages, policy support, post seed funding support, funding for full-fledged product realization, angel funding. As Dharmesh sir has already shared that we have raised more than 3.5 crores of a private fund and more than 4.5 crores of a free fund from the different stakeholders to support these startups. And many of them are currently doing extraordinary. We have a startups having customers ranging from 100 to 85,000. One startup has 85,000 customers. Few of them are now ready to have a next level of millions of startups funding, and they are approaching towards them. Many getting recognized at a national level, they won the national awards, which is a proud moment for the entire university, because from the state, we are the only incubation center having a national award in startups associated with us. Our startups are listed among top 10 promising startups of the Startup India campaigning done last year. And this year also, we are hopeful that we will be through this similar kind of achievements. So we wanted that our students, they should not be only the job seeker, but they should be also a job provider. And we are committed to give you that kind of an experience. So keep in touch with your IIC, the IIC coordinator, our incubation center, and we would love to extend as much as possible support to everyone who wants to get the benefit of the ecosystem. What are the main objective? So we have to develop a student-centric innovation and pre-incubation center. So these are the main objectives which already I have, I believe, discussed under my different discussion points. These are the key elements to cover into the student policy. That we have to later on, after the exercise of first or second year of second quarter of IIC implementation, we have to identify that with how many numbers of at least one student should be there with one idea. And in my design thinking, I always tell them that in a day, you come up with the 10 or 100 solutions. Every day, you come up with 100 innovative solutions for 100 problems, or 10 innovative solutions for 10 problems, starting doing brush to go to the bay. But unfortunate part, we do have a problems, we identify the solutions, but we never realize that solution, and that idea dies. Another morning, new ideas start born, getting born, and in the night, it again dies. Why don't you guys create a habit of recording those ideas? I have my own idea bank in my mobile. I keep writing the innovative idea and share with innovators, or I sometimes try to pursue those ideas and then share the solutions with the industry. So that is very important. And in fact, Professor Dharmesh has also briefed into my profile that on how I am connected with the industry. So this is very important at IIC that we segregate the different levels of innovation. We should segregate or like summarize the students with ideation level of an idea, summarize the students with institute level of idea, like the idea which is still with the institute has received the MVP and has not participated out of the institute. Then there are certain ideas we give an exposure to the university level. So now if the incubation center is hosting some hackathon, you come out from the institute with your 2 or 3 mentors, professor mentors, and 2 or 3 or 5 team members, and compete at an institute level. So then that record should be maintained. Then cluster wise, you participate in North Gujarat cluster or a Gujarat cluster, if it is a state, is a cluster. Then you go for a certain next level of a cluster. Pedagogy level of idea segregation can be done. Those who are having an extraordinary approach is done with some IPR, patents, and bring some learning to the academic practices. Those kind of a startups should be segregated. These are very unique and very high-tech, high-skill startups. So those learning should be shared with earlier clusters and help them improve their idea at a very initial level. We should have a academic recognition awards mechanism. We do have a DG awards, Director General's award, and if you see, many of the Director General student awardees are from the startup and innovation. So this is something which keeps you apart from the different levels of a competition. So those kind of an activity should be done. We have a list. We should have a list of common infrastructure. For example, how many Raspberry Pis are available? How many IoT devices are available? How many racks are available to the students for experiment? How many Wi-Fi routers are available up to that instant? What are the softwares available and which lab is available? So those kind of a common infrastructure map to be prepared and shared with the students and the mentor so that they can participate into the activity. Next is we should have identified mentors available at incubation center. And similarly with the your IIC, and those mentor can be a blend of an academy and industry. And that list and profile to be available to the students so that they can choose from that list. Here, what we do, we specifically take care of the mentor-mentee engagement agreement. So while any students associate with us, we assign them an official mentors and we create an engagement agreements that every fortnightly they will meet, they will talk, they will discuss about the progress and the learning will be shared with us. So this is the way we maintain the record keeping. And I engage, I even wanted to share with team IIC that you do not need to prepare any process which we have already prepared and proven. You can be in touch with us and we'll give you all the documentation which are available to us. And this is the way you do not have to reinvent the wheel. You just have to use those practices and implement it. We should have a very important thing, 16 hours working facility. So those who are a mentor of the innovation and startup of the students, and this is something which is out of the academia demand. But you have to be committed and dedicated. You have to go extra mile and support the innovators at any point of time. We have to understand they are doing it apart from their academy. Students are engaging themselves into innovations apart from academia. So whatever the time they'll have been left with, they engage and enroll that time into their innovation. And during that time, if they require your mentoring, you have to create a mechanism that how you can timely support them. Create a startup funnel. So from ideation, there may be 100. So create a funnel and a validation structure so that at the end, out of 100, we get 10 startups. It can be a one startup as well. But we should know that what is our funnel and at which stage, how many startups are there and how we can improve the outcome. So when we have started, we have a 100 to 10 ratio. Now when we have start, now today we have improved the practices. We have accelerated the pre-incubation process. We have helped refining the startup's idea. The ratio is now from 100 to 30. So it has improved a lot. It has been improved a lot. So if you see the progress of the incubation center, largely has happened from our own learnings. So similar will happen to you. Process and mechanisms for each activity, you have to define the docket that what is the process of engaging the students with workshop, seminar, FDPs or induction program for the innovators or design thinking kind of a week-long workshops. What is hackathons mechanism? So that all the mechanism and structure to be defined and duly available with all the innovation ambassador. So they do not have to think because there are a lot of activities goes in parallel. For the first semester students, you will do some different activities, and for the last semester, those who are already having a couple of projects on their hand have a different kind of a demand of the hackathon. So we have to create those processes and practices, and this is the responsibility of an IIC coordinator mainly to prepare it and make it available so that the other mentors can immediately implement it. Grant and funding. So various funding sources are available at Incubation Center. So for that, you do not have to run around. Do not have to go to door to door and ask for the opportunity. Just approach us and Ganpati University Incubation Center will help you getting the right source of funding. If possible, we'll in a coming days, we'll share one session on the how to get the funding and what are the sources of funding. In any ways, which we are already doing, but you don't know that this is also one way of doing the funding. So we have to also have a checklist. This is the checklist which we prepare usually at the incubation center, and we keep checking it. So suppose we have to check that whether the outreach, sensitization and culture development has been done, say yes. Support at idea generation stage we are providing, say yes. Support at IPR awareness and prior patents, yes. Support for POC, yes. So you have to have your own checklist, and IIC coordinator should have to maintain that checklist, that what stage and what support systems we are offering to the different startups. So this is very important to check the track and the progress of our each and every startups, each and every innovation. And this will help you even growing quarter on quarter. These are the necessary documents you have to prepare in order to share with all the IIC innovators. These are majorly available to us. You do not have to prepare, but have to have a handy documents available to your IIC so that you can share. And the reason to use predefined dockets from our side is that these dockets are standards. So once the applications comes to us for funding and other supports, we also do not have to ask any other informations from the apart from these processes. So application form, evaluation form, mentor-mentee agreements, space allocation letter, NDA to protect the idea, comparative price and POC structure, everything. So these are the dockets available to us. We'll share as and when required. Moving towards, so IIC should do collaboration and tie-ups. So there are major collaboration and tie-ups needed to improve the practices at our IIC. So tie-ups with industry, incubators, IPR firms, VC firms, various labs for testings, readings, standardization of the POC, different space, co-working space tie-ups. So for example, someone, a student from Rajkot is studying here and started working on one of the idea, and now he is an alumni. He is graduated already, and he wants to continue the idea as an enterprise. Then we should support them to have a working space available in Rajkot with no cost or a low cost. So these are the kind of mechanism we have to prepare in a longer run to support our alumni and our current students. And this is the way only we can build up a right strength so that we can support the startups. This is all about the induction programs of the IIC today. Now I am open for the question and answer as I have been given the ample minutes and I have probably utilized that. So I'm open for the question and answer.
Yes, so if students have any questions or faculties, you are invited. Saurabh sir, very nice information received from you today. ऐसा लगता है कि हमारे घर में ही वो सोने का कुंभ पड़ा है और हमको पता नहीं है.
थैंक यू सर, बट अब आप उसको यूज कीजिएगा.
Yeah, definitely, definitely.
Personally recommend.
We have one student already, they have proposed a project to us and we are about to connect with you. And I have already asked Sulabh sir to review internally and then we will send it to you. They are very, very intelligent and very hardworking students of second year.
Ji sir. So,
yes, any question?
Okay, Saurabh sir, one student has posted one question. The chat box, please see and give the answer.
Sir, what is operation? Can you please elaborate the question, Priyam? Priyam?
Priyam, please elaborate your question. What you want to ask?
In fact, they can unmute themselves even. It will be better to understand.
I just wanted to understand in which context.
Unmute करके बोल सकते हैं.
Priyam is asking about what is operation.
Sir, meanwhile there is one more question. Is there any prerequisite for starting a startup from one of the students?
A wheel is the only thing required. There is no prerequisite. See, there, I have seen into the startup ecosystem that even you can improve the idea. So in day or two, you can come up with certain opportunistic idea which you came across and you can start working on it. Many of us are the users of the different e-commerce platforms. And we know there are certain pros and cons of each and every. If even we improve those pros and cons and come up with another solution, we can be a next unicorn. So there is no prerequisites. It's just what we ask the innovator is to have a committed will. It's not something that for a fancy tag that I am a CEO or a founder of a startup. You should approach and pursue the startup industry. Will is required, commitment is required, because initially there are lot to do in pursuing and framing the right idea. There is no gain without pain.
Yes, any more questions?
Even any minor can also apply for the startup funding. In that case, there is a provision of giving a support to the financial support to the guardian, and later on the minor becomes a major. It takes over the entire structure in the mechanism. And in our diploma students' case, we are already doing it.
So, sir, a question from my side, that suppose a student is registering for idea level in startup and he or she is in, like in the case we have, maybe in second year, then how they are supposed to balance their academics and this idea development?
See, sir, so first of all, when they start working on the idea at a second year, for example, they have to come up with their at least 3 years of a plan, because they are with us for the next 3 years. A certain milestone that what they are even expecting from the incubation center and an institute to support during those 3 years. And these policies allows them to pursue the same idea up to next 5 years once they graduate. So alumni with the 5 years of association, so they have a long timeline of 8 years to pursue their idea. So slowly and gradually they can cope up with the demand and the development. But my suggestion is they should spend more time on validating the idea, because this startup life is very, I can say, unpredictable life. If you come up with a good idea, you should start working on it and start solving those problems immediately. And you move into the market as a pioneer, the way the Mark Zuckerberg has done, right? So even the product was not that sustainably ready, but he moved to the market and say, I'm the first one to offer this. And similar time, the Orkut, the product of Google, was struggling. So Mark got two benefits. One, he's from the student fraternity, so acceptance and youngsters, he knows well. And the other one is he has the right timing. So don't wait. If you come up with any idea, don't even think that I am not the expert to solve this. Don't try to do everything from the scratch. Don't try to do everything at your own. If you are not a good programmer, but you come up with a good solution, come to us, we'll fund you, get it done by the industry. You manage it, you become a right manager. So there is no extra burden is going to come on the students if they are well planned. And this is the reason we emphasize on building up a team, sir. So if the team is there, it is well balanced.
Great, great.
Really, yes, sir.
Yes, so someone any questions me, from any student?
Yeah, someone asked me, Rahul. Rahul has asked me, is it necessary to file patent before starting startup in case of product-based startups in India? So I would say it is not compulsory to file a patent, but yes, a product is something which can be visualized, bought, and even decoded. And India is a country of a fertile brain. So what happens if you are offering something which is very innovative, breakthrough, and a kind of an innovation which you come up with? There may be a chance of tampering your innovation. There may be a chance of stealing your innovation. So I would always suggest that you protect it first and then start production. And what happens? Once you protect it, you have the patents, you protect it, you started selling the products in the market. When you reach to the investor will also see a lot of value in investing into the protected goods. And because they know, yeah, this is something which is innovative, have been saved through the rights of the patents or any IPR mechanism, so I'm well protected. So my money is not going to go anywhere. And because he is the investor, he knows how to get his money back. Right? Koi agar aapko paisa dega to usko pata hoga uska paisa hai usko kaise nikalna hai. So that investor will also scale up your business like anything. And the good suggestion I have received from one of the eminent venture capitalists is the right investor is the one who becomes your first customer and the first salesman. Try to find out those investors who are your first customer and the first salesman. If that kind of an investor you have got it, believe me, you will be through your business.
Okay. Any students or faculties? We are very close to our timeline. So, Sulabh sir, are we taking a snap of the students with camera?
Yes, sir. We need to take
yes,
a
sir.
Photo. So, along with me, Mr. Akshay Patel, our incubation manager, has joined today, and he has shared the contact details for further support in the chat box. I request all the students to you can capture those details and keep it handy with you. In any case, you can always approach directly to us, but I would recommend that keep in loop with Dharmesh sir, then Umang sir and Sulabh sir, so that we can organizedly support you.
Yeah, and there are some students from our ICT department at main campus, so they shall go through their department. Okay. Yeah, so all are requested to switch on your cameras so that we have a very nice click.
Yes, all the students, please turn on your camera.
Students and faculty.
Yes.
Meanwhile, Saurav sir, it was very fruitful session. Really, we got to know many things, and it will definitely help our students to motivate themselves for the startup. And we have a few students from semester one right now to semester two, right? So they are enough motivated from our, actually we had 3 days event of IBM since from 15th April, and okay. Technically they are boosted enough, and now by the startup activities you are boosting them, so it will be a great thing. It's a great combination.
I must tell this is a really a right time for them to pursue the idea, because they are at a first semester. They have enough time to be in touch with us, be in touch with the experts, and be in touch with the ecosystem enablers. So by the time they complete, I'm not surprised if anyone comes with a very unicorn solution.
Yes,
I just wanted to tell you, sir, just wanted to add one thing. On 17th of September 2020, Honorable Prime Minister of India, Shri Narendra Modi Sahab, he has inaugurated one of our startup.
Oh,
yes. And today, in month of April, we have a revenue of more than 2 to 3 millions.
Wow.
So this is the speed of the startup should do it. And for technology startup, a one small app is enough if it is a right app. Solving the right problem. For example, I was the customer of CRED, C-R-E-D, CRED.
Oh, yes.
I was among the first 100 customer, I could say, when I have subscribed on CRED. And last year and this year, they are the main franchisee provider to IPL.
Yeah,
they grow like anything. See, yeah. So for those who are into the technology, for them, it's a gold mine.
Correct. We would like to also inform you, sir, that one of our students has got internship and placement in the same great company, and it's a very high company, right? So, and that also a good news to worry. Okay. Yeah, thank you very much. So, snap is taken, Sulabh sir?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, it is taken.
Okay. So, Sulabh sir, please do vote of thanks.
Yes, sir. Respected Professor Dharmesh Darji sir, HOD, CSA department, and respective faculties, and our valuable students. I, Sulabh Bhatt, on behalf of ICT, Gadwad University, would like to express sincere thanks to Dr. Saurav Dave, the Dean of our Startup and Incubation Department, Gadwad University. Sir, I am very much thankful to you on behalf of entire ICT team for providing us for providing our students and faculties various options available with us. Actually, it is something like we have already many things available with us, but we are searching outside. So I especially like the key elements which we can cover for the awareness of students who are willing for some startups, and also the grants and fundings provided by the university. So I am very much thankful to you again. And we all are inspired by your great words. So thank you very much.
Thank you
for your time and support.
Yeah, and
thank you.
And thank you to all students for sparing their valuable time and faculties. Actually, it is really going to be valuable to you if you can utilize it, right, Saurav?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, all faculties also.
All participants are requested to provide your feedback. Once you will provide your feedback, you will immediately get the certificates in your email.
Yeah, so this feedback link will give you the certificate in your email. You have to fill that feedback. Fine. All students are supposed to do that. Professor, have you posted the link?
Yes, I have posted the link. Again, I am posting.
Yeah.
So shall I leave the meeting now?
Sure, sir.
Thank you for sharing that.
Thank you.